Hello, brethren. Pray the Lord again. This is another time that God is giving us. Eridad Milton Shissa is my name, the vicar and subdean St. Andrew's Cathedral, as it has always been. I thank God for this another opportunity, and I serve a God of another chance, and it's what I'm coming to talk about this time around, and our personality of discussion is the man, Jonah. And so before we start, let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that we have another chance, another opportunity to share your word. Because another chance you give us is very, very valuable, and we pray the Lord you bless us as we share together in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And so, brethren, I come with a portion, and this time also again is the book of Jonah. Jonah is one of the prophets that we find in the Old Testament. These prophets were divided into two. There were those that were called major prophets and those that were called minor prophets. Not because their messages were major or because their messages were minor, but because it depends on the volume, on the bigness of the chapters, of the message, of the message that they delivered. Like Isaiah, you see over 60 chapters, like Jeremiah, like Ezekiel. Those ones are called major prophets. And now the minor prophets were small ones, like having one chapter or two chapters. And now this time we're talking about Jonah. Jonah is actually four chapters. And this book of Jonah, this man, Jonah, the prophet Jonah, was sent to go and deliver a message to a people that were outside Palestine. And this was to go to a place called Nineveh. And Nineveh was outside the land of the Jews. And so Prophet Jonah is the man that actually we are reflecting about now. And his name, remember, every Hebrew name has a meaning. And Jonah, according to the searches that I did, the name means dove. And dove, remember, in the biblical settings, a dove is a bird of peace. Call it a dove or pigeon, a humble bird. The reason why Jesus, when he was preaching, told his people that as you move during the generations that you'll be in, be as humble as a dove, but of course as wise as serpents. And so a dove symbolized humility, or rather peace. And so Jonah, that's what it means. But I just want to mention that God, in these chapters of Jonah, chapters 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, God shows himself as a God of another chance. And this is what I'm coming to talk about. And so when another chance comes, when a second opportunity comes, what I mention now is seize it, use it. And so the prophet Jonah, remember, first, he disobeyed God. He many times he complained about what God had done. And this is the summary of what the message is all about. And then Jonah suffered severe depression when God had given another chance to the people of Nineveh. And remember, God works out something to accomplish his plan. When he purposes, God fulfills what he has purposed. And so, briefly, I just want us to run through the four chapters of this book. But remember, first of all, that Jonah was a prophet who was a missionary prophet, a prophet sent to go and preach to other people, sent to go and preach to the Gentiles. He was a missionary prophet. Actually, when you do searches, you'll discover that actually, if there are any, then he is the only one that could have been sent to go and and fulfill the commission, as live around the New Testament, where Jesus tells his disciples, his apostles that he had commissioned, go and preach the gospel to all nations. Now, Jonah in the Old Testament is the one that has been sent, just like fulfilling Genesis 12:3. When God called Abraham, he said, through you, all the nations of the earth shall be blessed. And so Jonah becomes this kind of prophet that God sends to go and preach to the Ninevites, the people that had sinned, and God had mercy upon them. Now, chapter 1 of the book of Jonah, the Bible talks about Jonah being called, the word coming to Jonah. And what we discover in this is that God's love will never let you go. When God calls you, number one, God's love will never let you go. Remember in chapter 1, now the word of the Lord came to Jonah, the son of Amittai, saying, arise and go to Nineveh, that great city, and cry out against it, for their wickedness has come before me. That's the word the Lord says. But Jonah arose to flee to Tarshish from the presence of the Lord. He went down to Joppa and found a ship going to Tarshish. So he paid his fare and went down into it to go with them to Tarshish from the presence of the Lord. You remember, Jonah thought that he was running away from the presence of the Lord. Yes, you can never successfully run away from God or from his call. When he calls you, he has called you. And so the word had come, but the man decided to take off. And this Jonah, the Bible says that actually was one of the good preachers of the time. Actually, the Bible talks about him in 2 Kings chapter 14, verse 25, as a preacher. And that's the evidence. But instead of going to Nineveh, Jonah runs away. Now, my brothers and sisters, this shows us that you can run, well, you can decide to run away from God, but you never hide from him. You can decide to run, but you never hide from him. So sometimes, the storms that we face in our own lives are our own making as a result of our own disobedience. Now, Jonah runs away, goes the different direction. And you see in verse chapter 1, verse 4, but the Lord sent a great storm, wind on the sea, and it was so mighty that the ship was about to break up. So sometimes there are challenges that we face. Jonah was called by God to go the other way, to go to Nineveh, but he decided to go the other way. My brothers and sisters, this is a great lesson that I learn as a servant of the Lord in the house of the Lord, that God's love will never let us go. When God has purposed that you are the one to be, to go and preach in that city, to go to that person, to go to those places and meet the people and preach to them, even if you decide to take the other direction, God is mercy, because he desires that sinners should not perish, but repent and live. That is his purpose, and it's from his word. You can run away, but you cannot hide from God's presence. That's point number one, and that's chapter number one. Chapter number two of the book of Jonah, the Bible says that Jonah's prayer and repentance, of course, after he was trying to run away, God prepared a big fish. And in verse 17, by the way, the Bible says that a great fish was prepared to swallow Jonah. You can read the story and complete it, because actually it has details there. I'm just picking a few things because of the time that we may not be having enough. Now, God's love can reach you no matter how far you have fallen. That's point number two. God's love can reach you no matter how far you have fallen, no matter how far you have gone. And in chapter 2, Jonah, while in the belly of the fish, the Bible says, he prayed to the Lord his God from the fish's belly. And he said, I cried out to the Lord because of my affliction, and he answered me. Out of the belly of the Sheol I cried, and you heard my voice. So Jonah cries. And this is why I'm bringing point number two, that God's love can reach us wherever we, how, no matter how far, no matter how high, no matter how low we are fallen, but God's love can fetch us from there. And so however desperate that you can be, or however hopeless that you can be, your situation may seem to be that, it's never too late for God to save you from there. Remember, Jonah hit bottom, rock bottom, in the fish's belly. From inside the fish, he prayed, as we have seen in verse 2. There is no situation that God cannot rescue us from. And this gives me the confidence that God can rescue us from whatever situation. It's just the matter of the heart. The posture of your heart is what matters a lot in the presence of the Lord. So Jonah turned to God even when he was deep inside there. And that's point number two in chapter 2 of the book of Jonah. And so God's love can reach us. And I'm glad that I read this book, that I still read it. And by then our translation, I translated the Bible with my colleagues. But the first chapter that we dealt with, that the first chapter that they gave us to translate, I translated into Roma Saba. But the first chapter that we dealt with, the first book in the Bible that we dealt with, the Book of Jonah. Because it has a lot of things actually we picked from there. And I remember the first time that I put a pen down to translate the Bible into my language. And these things actually sunk deep in me. I said, well, God searches, God reaches out no matter how far we're fallen. And the reason why, he lifts us up variously. And so I thank God for this man, Jonah, that as long as you cry to him sincerely, God can fetch you back. Chapter number 3. And that is point number 3 that I'm taking you into. Chapter 3, the Bible says, talks about Jonah now, after coming out of the fish, he now goes to Nineveh to preach. And the point that I make here is God is mercy or God is love means you get a second chance, another opportunity. That's what it means. God is mercy is for second, another opportunity. You can call it second chance if you want, but second elapses, but you can call it another chance. So God was persistent in giving Jonah another chance. And so in here, in chapter 3 now, verse 1, now the word of the Lord came to Jonah the second time, saying, arise now and go to Nineveh, that great city, and preach to it the message that I tell you. Pray the Lord, brethren, that God gives another chance to Jonah to go. So this word, he took it up now. So the word coming encouraged him. So he moved on. And so he went. Jonah was, you remember, I've already mentioned, actually, he was the only prophet sent to go to the Gentiles. And he was going to the foreign land. Now, a second chance was not only to Jonah, remember. Second chance was not only to Jonah because actually, Ninevites had missed the first opportunity when Jonah was taking the other direction. Now, these Ninevites were also receiving a second chance. A second chance to Jonah, a second chance to Ninevites. I mean, another chance to Jonah, another chance to the people of Nineveh. And so, my brothers and sisters, God is very, very, very persistent with what he does. And from time immemorial, he had been showing this. He gives another chance, another chance, another chance. Actually, until, I've written here, that until Judgment Day, during our times here. Now, chapter 4 is what I'm bringing you to in the book of Jonah. Actually, it's one of the shortest books that we find in the New Testament, in the Old Testament, I mean. Chapter 4, God's love extends to all his creation. Remember, it's not only Palestine, but it has extended to the Ninevites, the Gentiles over the other side. So God's love is for everyone and wants to be merciful to every person, city or nation on earth, big and small. Actually, in Hebrew, the big ones are called gadol. In Hebrew, the small ones are called katon. So whether they are big or small, whether tall or short, God's mercy, God's love extends to everyone. The reason why when Jonah went, the king of Nineveh commanded everyone to repent, including their livestock, cattle, sheep, whatever they were, that everyone should repent and live. So God's amazing attribute is mercy. God's amazing characteristic is mercy. And mercy in this context means being kind and good to a people who do not deserve it. That's why the Bible talks about God's mercies are new every morning. Actually, he has mercy. We don't deserve it. You and I do not deserve anything like that. But God loves us. God takes care of us. And so, my brothers and sisters, God's love is extended to us all through Christ Jesus Christ until the judgment day. And so, if God is merciful to us, we should be merciful to others as well. And the Bible says, what God has done to us, let us also do to others, being merciful. But God's love is extended to everyone, you and me. And the reason why I can be able to sit here and talk about God's love, I'm not the best, unworthy, completely unworthy, but God's love searches and gives me another chance. Every day we fall, every moment we collapse, but God's love is merciful. Now, Psalm 86 verse 15, the Bible says that the Lord God is merciful and gracious. He is slow to anger. That is Psalm 86 verse 15. He is steadfast and he is faithful. That is something that I treasure, my brothers and sisters. And even the book of Micah, chapter 7, verse 18, the Bible says, who is like a God? Who is a God like you, pardoning iniquity? God pardons iniquity and brings us back. So my brothers and sisters, the Bible is full of people who benefited from another chance. As I wind up, God gives another chance. The first person here that we're talking about is Jonah. He benefited, and the people of Nineveh also benefited. How about Jacob, the man, the trickster, given another chance? Pray the Lord. How about David? How about Samson? Read to those stories and you discover that God gives another chance. How about Peter? How about Paul? Now all those, how about me and how about you? God gives another chance. So my brothers and sisters, may the God give us another chance. This time around that we can be able to continue loving and serving him. Jonah was given another chance. David was given another chance. All these men were given another chance. Jacob was given another chance. And so that Moses was given another chance. You know, all those people were another chance. And so I'm a product of another chance. And may God continue being with us, because his mercy is anew every morning. So my brothers and sisters, God is good that has given us this opportunity. And I wind up with this statement saying, every moment of your life is a second chance. I have said it before and I keep saying it, that every moment of your life is another chance that God has given you. Every moment of my life is another chance that God has given me. Every day that comes is another chance that God has given me. Every minute that God has given me is another chance. Because it's all about living to please God. And so where we fail today, we polish, we put right, so that another day will come. And so these are learning experiences. Jonah is the man that we're talking about today. And may God bless us as we think about his message, reading the four chapters and discovering something more for our own life and for the lives of others. May God bless you and watch over you. And may God bless the work of our hands, so that we may continue loving and serving him in this land of the living. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.